And so I hope you all are now quite aware of psychrometry and various psychrometric processes. So once you have a knowledge of the psychrometry, then the application of that psychrometry is in air conditioning system design that we'll see in this unit. So students, the learning objectives for today's session are we are going to study air handling system and its function. Then we'll discuss air transmission aspects in air conditioning system. Then we'll see some general rules while designing the duct and classification of duct, and then various the principle involved in duct design that we'll see afterwards by applying Bernoulli's equations. Then we'll see various dynamic and static losses, so the fan total pressure, and if time permits, we'll see some estimation of pressure losses. So let us start with air conditioning. I hope everybody knows now what is air conditioning. So in air conditioning means we are cooling or heating, humidify or dehumidify the air, then filter, and then the distribution. Okay, after processing the air for its temperature, with respect to its temperature, humidity, and then next is purity, means filtration. Finally, such conditioned air you need to transmit to your conditioned space, and you have to maintain the indoor air quality. I'm audible, Vinayak? I hope I'm loud and clear. Okay, so in air conditioning, after processing the air, you have to maintain the indoor air quality by supplying the air uniformly into your conditioned spaces. And ultimately, while doing all these things, energy efficiency you have to also consider, that because that aspect is very much important, because you are dealing with a vapor compression cycle. So the power consuming or power guzzler is in that particular system is a compressor. And finally, whatever you are doing with the air, you have to use that conditioned air wisely. So various types of air conditioning systems that we already discussed are first unit type systems or equipment. There are two particular unit type equipment that we all know, which is window type room air conditioner and split type air conditioner. So, and second is the package type unit, and which may be a self-contained or a split type is units. So next one is a VRV, and VRV stands for variable refrigerant volume, and VRF stands for variable refrigerant flow type systems. That we'll see in a while what is VRV and VRF. Then last is central plants. Okay, I think central plants are there are two types of central air conditioning plants. First one is the central DX type. Okay, direct expansion. DX stands for direct expansion type plants with air handling units. And second one is the centrally chilled water plants with air handling unit or fan coil, chill beams, embedded chilled water pipes in slabs and walls, etc. So these are the basic, you may say, types of air conditioning systems based on its application and its construction. Now, there is the one thumb rule that I would like to share with you. So while designing the air conditioning system, the general thumb rule is that for per tier of air conditioner or the per tier of refrigeration, you require 400 CFM, or you are handling 400 CFM air, okay, or vice versa. For 400 CFM requirements, you need one tier of refrigeration or air conditioning system. Or for per square feet basis, so for per square feet, you required one CFM. Suppose your house is So suppose you have your office space is 10 by 10, means it is 100 square feet. So for 100 square feet, you required 100 CFM of air. CFM stands for cubic of feet per minute. So your office of 10 by 10, 10 feet by 10 feet office needs 100 cubic of feet per minute air, okay, in order to create a comfort condition inside that office space. Okay, likewise, you can calculate the TR required in your house, CFM as well as TR required in your house. You just measure your house, your bedroom, or if you have to condition the hall, then you just measure its dimension and calculate by using this thumb rule how much CFM of air is required or how much TR of AC you need to fit in your house. Clear? And again, why this or this thumb rule tells you that 400 CFM per TR. So suppose I am having 1000 TR system. So 400 into 1000. So it comes to be 400 into 1000. So it comes to be 4 lakh. Okay, 4 lakh CFM. So it's a huge air, 4 lakh cubic of feet per minute of air, and it is very difficult to handle that or to supply that air by natural way or some small fans. Okay, for that you need a very huge blowers, like in case of city center mall or the malls where your air conditioning requirement is in 1000 or 1500 TR. You require very huge blowers, and we all know that these blowers are energy consuming devices. Screen is not visible to you all. Screen is visible. You just check out what's the problem. For large system, again, for large system, while I'm discussing the various types of systems, unit system, package system, variable refrigerant flow, or central system, when to choose out of these four. So there is again one thumb rule that for large system means greater than 100 TR, we generally go for this central air conditioning plant. Or less than 100, you may go for variable refrigerant or variable refrigerant volume or variable refrigerant flow type system or package system also use, but you need a number of package system in that case. Depends on the TR. Clear? So the first is window AC, as I told you that unit, as I told you that unitary systems are first window AC that we all aware of. This diagram shows the window AC, and at bottom split AC is shown. The split AC, we know that it is divided into two parts or split into two parts. One is the condenser and compressor, which is this box, and the rectangular is the fan coil unit, which is fitted inside your house or office. Okay, and again on the right hand side you can observe that this indoor unit comprises of evaporator, and the outdoor unit is comprises of compressor and condenser, which is shown on this slide. Okay, I think it is this diagram is quite self-explanatory. So these two are unitary systems, and when you are going to choose this system, when your TR requirement is less. We know that a window AC is of one comes in 1 TR, 1.5 TR capacity, and split AC comes up to 5 TR and 10 TR. So depending upon your TR of requirement, you may go for a small cooling load, you go for unitary system as shown in this diagram. Next is variable refrigerant flow or variable refrigerant volume type of systems. In that case, you can observe that such at the central, this variable refrigerant flow system is shown, where compressor and condenser is fitted in that box. And again, like in case of split AC, clear, it is supplying the refrigerant to the different devices shown in the diagram. One is indoor unit, as we explained in split AC. This is a fan coil unit, cassette type AC. Such a cassette type of AC is also shown here. And in this cassette type of unit, or any one out of this, okay, the coils are it is it's the evaporator, you can observe here, and chilled water or in case of vapor, refrigerant flow system, instead of chilled water, refrigerant may you may pass directly the refrigerant from the expansion wall comes to this evaporator. It cools the air in the room, and that refrigerant flows from this side. So this is refrigerant in, refrigerant out, and air, you may supply fresh air in between. This is the primary air, and part of the air in the room is also recirculated. So such type of cassette type units you can observe in hospitals or the offices of having 500 square feet size, very big offices. Such cassette type of units you can also observe. Next one is the central air conditioning plants. In case of central air conditioning plants, as you can observe that the central air conditioning plants is having vapor compression refrigeration cycle as shown in here. Evaporator, then condenser, valve, evaporator, compressor, condenser, and expansion valve. This is a vapor compression cycle, and this is a water cool condenser. So water cool condenser is shown is here. This condenser is connected to cooling tower, so that's why it is called as a water cool condenser. And this evaporator, as you can observe that this evaporator is supplying the refrigerant to this air handling unit, AHU, air handling unit. And this in air handling unit, evaporator, again cooling coils are fitted, and with the help of this fan, you can blow air over these cooling coils, and you will get the desired condition air here. And part of the air from that condition space is again you can take back and again recirculate. So this is the recirculation. Okay, and if you don't want to recirculate, that air is directly exhausted. So what I'm trying to say is that in central air conditioning plant, there is a separate compressor house or a chiller house, and this chiller is producing this in some cases directly refrigerant is flowing. That's why I have shown you that central plant is with a DX type. In DX type, this in the refrigerant is directly in contact with cooling coil, directly supplied to the cooling coil. And in case of chill water system, evaporator is used to chill the water, and this water is then passed through the cooling coil, and then coil cools the air. So refrigerant to chill water, chill water to air. Understood? So such type of circuit. So these are the central AC plants, and such type of central AC plants are used when your air conditioning capacity is more than 100 or 400 TR, you go for this system. So in this central AC plant, you can observe that this air handling unit plays an important role. So let us see what is this air handling is all about. So these are the component, important components shown here. At the bottom, you can observe the chiller. So this is one layout of chiller which shows the operator, and in the second actual chiller, it's shown. Okay, you can observe that three compressors on the top, then at the middle, evaporator, this is insulated evaporator, and at the bottom, water cool condenser. The green pipe is connected to this section, and this is the condenser, the water cool condenser. This is a chiller of one mall that I've studied, the central air conditioning system at that time. So I just put that image here. This is a three-stage air conditioning, three-stage compressor is used here. Screw type. And on the top, you can observe that because fan plays an important role, because the distribution and movement of air, a huge amount of air in thousands or lakhs of air, this is possible with the help of such type of blowers. Okay, we'll see in a while what are the different blowers. Then again, come back to our air distribution system. So in air conditioning system, it is very important not only to handle with the or to condition the air as per the environment is demanding, but also that after conditioning the air, transmission of that air from the chiller or air handling unit to the condition space is very important. Okay, so very first thing your while designing the air conditioning system, you have to do is the it should convey the specified rate of airflow to prescribed locations. Then it should be economical in combined initial cost, fan operating cost, and cost of the building space. So it is also important not only to design the system such that it will give you the desired airflow, but economy of building and fan that you are going to use is also important. Next, it should not transmit or generate the objectionable noise. In most of the cases, you can observe that air conditioner is fitted. It may be a unitary or a central AC, but the duct through which conditioned air is distributed inside the room, that duct is creating a loud noise. That is again not desirable. So these three important points you need to consider before designing your air conditioning system. So generally at the time of designing AC, the required airflow rates you can calculate from load calculation. I think this part we have already studied while discussing the psychrometry processes, or when we solve the numericals. At that time we have already calculated the mass flow rate of air required. Okay, so from the psychrometry calculation you'll get the desired quantity of air you have to handle as per your requirement. Next is air handling unit. As I told you, air handling unit plays a very important role. So as its name suggests, it is going to handle air, which is its working fluid. And this air handling design is very important. The primary function of air handling unit is to transmit the process air from the air conditioning plant to the conditioned space and distribute it properly within the conditioned space. Okay. And the typical this air handling unit consists of a duct system. That duct may include a supply duct, return duct, cooling and heating coils, humidifier, dehumidifier, and air filters, which is most important, and dampers to control the flow rate of air, and an air distribution. And air distribution system comprises of various types of outlet for supply and inlet air returns. And finally, supply and return air fans, which provide necessary energy to move the air throughout the system. So air handling unit comprises of duct, air distribution system, which is actually passing the air in the room. And finally, the supply and return fan you have to choose and design carefully. Now, where does air come from and to go in central air conditioning plant? So we can observe here. So this very first thing, duct, the air passes through various these sections. You can observe here, this is called as the air ducts, and fan, two blowers you can observe here. Okay, and the top portion is for return line. This green arrow indicates the air is returned from the room. So part of the air is recirculated like this, and part is expelled into atmosphere. Why part of the air is fresh air is added through this side? Because fresh air is needed to create to reduce the odor in the room, to create a freshness, plus to increase the oxygen level. So for that you are going to add the fresh air and remove the recirculated air. And this air then passes through heating. If you need to heat, then heating coils are all there. Cooling coils shown in blue, and this air, then this blower throws this air inside the conditioned space. So this is the supply line and this is the return line. Okay, so this is how air circulates. And what is an AHU? I think the diagram I discussed in the previous slide, this is nothing but air handling unit. The name is explained that air handling unit, this unit handles the air and condition the air as per your requirement. The top this diagram at the top shows the air handling unit, and at the bottom you can observe the actual cross section of the air handling unit, where you can observe very first is the damper, then the coil, these copper coils you can observe, which these coils are nothing but cooling and heating coils. And before that, filter is here, the white color filter, then cooling or heating coils, and your blower. So this is the air handling unit looks like. again one cut out of this air handling unit you can see. So outside air is taken, first filter that air, then heat will. I will tell you later what is the heat will, but right now it is you just keep my word, this heat will is for increasing the energy efficiency of this system. So filter the air, then that first filter, second filter, then cooling or heating, then UV light if you required very clean air, like in case of pharmaceutical industry, then you can also employ UV light. That UV light is anti, we know that it is having antibacterial property, so it kills the bacteria. So UV light, then again third filter, and if you have to humidify the air, then steam humidification you can observe, and this is the supply air. Okay, and part of the air from the room you can take back to the system. Okay, and you can observe that part of the air, for example, say 50% of air is again recirculated back, and 50% is exhausted into atmosphere. Okay, but before exhausting that air into atmosphere, you are going to recover energy from that air. That's why heat will is employed here. Okay, this is one of the major to increase the energy efficiency. And where you are going to employ, of course, you are going to employ such a system where you are handling huge amount of air, which is in lakhs of CFM, not for a small unitary system, of course. Now, again, air handling unit, one actual air handling unit is shown, where you can observe that first number one indicates the supply duct, second indicates the fan compartment, third vibration isolator, four is heating and cooling coil, filter compartment is fifth, and sixth is mixed, means recirculate, mixing of fresh air with the recirculated air. Yeah, so A2 is shown. Again, this is the IoT based AHU, because the AHU needs to handle a huge amount of air. So nowadays, Internet of Things, you may say the automation is also employed in the air handling units, where air is the various parameters of the air, means air flow, then air temperature, humidity is controlled with the help of various sensors and all that. So such type of IoT based air handling units are nowadays available. This is again water cooled chiller with AHU. I think this is already explained, that this chilled water comes out of the chiller, is then passed through AHU, and AHU then the chilled water cools the air which is supplied to your room. Now, first important part of air conditioning is to convey, or AHU is to convey, the specified rate of airflow to prescribed location as per the needs. So first, few general rules that you need to remember. First, air should be conveyed as directly as possible to save space, power and material, because that conditioned space is very energy intensive commodity now. Because you have spent lots of energy in the compressor to cool that air, to heat or humidify the air, so you doesn't want to waste that energy. So air should be directly conveyed. Then sudden changes in direction should be avoided. So while designing this air distribution system, sudden changes or bends you have to avoid. Then diverging section should be gradual. So if you have to diverge the duct, then the divergent angle needs to be less than or equal to 20. Then aspect ratio should be as close as possible, as close to 1, okay, which is in case of circular ducts. Okay, and air velocity should be within a permissible limit. And of course, to reduce the noise, noise is a very important parameter in this thing, because you are using fan, and fan creates lots of noise. So while designing the system, you have to also consider the air velocities, and to create a desired air velocities, the noise will also generate, and you have to fit some air attenuation, noise reducing devices, which will help you to keep this noise under control. And last is duct material should be as smooth as possible to reduce the friction. All these six general rules we'll see elaborately in the coming session. Then classification of duct. Of course, the duct that that is carrying the air from air handling unit to the room is there are three types of based on the air pressure and turbulence. So first is low pressure system, which handles the air velocity less than 10 meter per second. Medium pressure is again handling the velocity less than or equal to 10 meter per second, but static pressure difference is there. Okay, in case of low pressure and medium pressure, you can observe low pressure system static pressure is less than or equal to 5 centimeter of water, and in case of medium it is 15 centimeter of water. And high pressure system velocity is more than 10 meter per second, and static pressure is between 15 to 25 centimeter of water column. Next, high velocities in the ducts result. If you suppose your plant is at fifth floor and you have to condition, you have to supply the conditioned air to floor one, to fifth floor to first floor. While doing this, of course, the first thing that comes to your mind is, sir, I'm supplying air with very high velocity so that I can achieve or I can, and the air can reach in a short time in that particular first floor in our case. But while increasing the velocity, you have to keep in your mind that a smaller duct and if while to have a high velocity, you can have design a smaller duct because smaller ducts create a high velocity air, and which also reduce the initial cost. The second thing is high pressure drop is also you have to consider while increasing the velocity. The pressure drop is also high, so you need a larger fan for power consumption. And third is increased noise, because as you are going to increase the air velocity, noise will also increase. So that for that you required a noise attenuation device. So here are some examples of recommended air velocities for various applications. For residence application, you can have air in between 3 to 5 meter per second. For theaters, it is 4 to 6.5 meter per second. And for restaurants, it may be 7.5 to 10 meter per second velocity you can keep. Then duct layout, you can see the duct that you are going, that is conveying air from air handling unit to the your space, office space or the room. Is the duct design is quite complicated, as you can observe here, that lots of branches and sub branches you can observe that. And while designing this duct, you have to keep in your mind few important things that we will see what are the important aspects while designing the duct. But for a moment, just observe the duct and how the duct networks actually looks like. Again, if that conditioned air is supplied to the room, there are few practical aspects that you have to consider. Like sometimes, suppose air is coming from this side, but you can observe that the person is who is standing at the middle of the room is not feeling the conditioned air, because air is flowing like this. Okay. In second case, suppose your air supply diffuser is here, that is supplying air like this. The person which is beneath that supply is not feeling the conditioned air. So such type of problems will occur. We'll see in coming lectures what is this phenomena is and how to reduce this. This is related to noise, that suppose you are returned up, as you observe that in air handling unit is there is one fan nearer to the return line. If that fan is very nearer to your room, then you can that you can observe the noise, or you can hear the noise created by the fan. To reduce that, you can change your layout like this. Okay, by changing the layout, you can reduce the noise. Okay? This is one of the examples shown. So this is the duct network and condensation or your duct work. This is also interesting thing where in most of the buildings having the central air conditioning system, the path carrying the duct, okay, is decolored, and this decoloring of the that walls, okay, nearer to the ducts is because of condensation of duct, which we call as a sweating of duct. You can observe that water droplets are just condensed over this duct, which looks like a sweating duct. It's sweating. That's why it is called as a sweating of duct phenomena. We'll see why this happens. Next is the calculation for while designing the duct. Few important things that we have to keep in our mind. First is while designing the duct, well, there are, as fluid is flowing through a pipe, as in case of fluid mechanics you studied that, there are various losses. Okay, so such type of losses you have to consider while designing your duct, so that you can have a desired air velocity inside your condition space. So flow through the ducts. So fundamental equation used in air conditioning while designing the duct is Bernoulli's equation. And this Bernoulli's equation is valid between any two points in the flow field when the flow is steady, irrotational, inviscid, and incompressible. Okay. So if you apply the, I think everybody knows the Bernoulli's equation, and you may write the Bernoulli's equation between any two points, suppose point one and point two. Of the duct, then, which is P1 upon rho g plus V1 square upon twice g plus Z1, and at point 2, which is P2 by rho g plus V2 square by twice g plus Z2, which is nothing but the total head. So P by rho g is the pressure head. So in this equation, this is the pressure head. Second one is the velocity head, and Z is the static head. I think you all aware of this different factors in this equation. So the Bernoulli's equation comprises of pressure head, velocity head, and static head as shown here. Now you can write down this equation in terms of pressure, total pressure. So total pressure is for that equation becomes P1 upon rho V1 square by 2 plus rho GZ1, and which is denoted by PT. Clear? And the above equation shows that there is no frictionless flow. Clear? There is some total pressure. Okay, sorry. The above equation implies that for frictionless flow through a duct, total pressure remains constant along the duct. But in real case or in actual practice, we know that each fluid is having, or all the fluids are having, some finite viscosity. So you have to consider that viscosity while studying the fluid flow. And that's why there is one more parameter is added to the above equation, which is known as the head loss. Okay. So what is this head loss? This head loss is nothing but while fluid flows through a pipe or any through a duct, okay, some energy is lost in overcoming the friction between the fluid and the pipe, and this is called as a head loss. And this head loss will cause total pressure to decrease in the flow direction, and hence you can modify the Bernoulli's equation by adding this head loss in your equation. So you can observe that apart from the terms that you already know, one term H1 is shown here, and this H1 is nothing but, or HL, sorry, HL is nothing but the head loss. Okay, and to overcome the fluid friction and the resulting head, a fan is required, because we know that because of the fluid friction, some energy is lost. So how your air will reach at the end from fifth floor to suppose first floor, because of this fluid friction, it may happen that air may not reach at floor one, or very less amount of air is reaching at floor one. So because low or no air will not serve the purpose. Okay, because in the case of air conditioning, the definition was to treat the air with respect to temperature, humidity, purity, and last one is air motion. So air motion is very important in air conditioning. So you have to deal with this head loss, and to overcome this fluid friction or this head loss, you have to use fan. So fan will overcome this loss and will supply the required or desired air to your room. And again, when it comes to fan, then fan total pressure is again, this concept is employed here. And what is that fan total pressure? So the second equation, you can observe that fan total pressure you can calculate by adding this head loss and the head loss in the Bernoulli's equation. And this gives you the fan total pressure. And if you put the fan total pressure in this equation, this is the quantity of air you have to handle that you already know that CFMA of air you required. FTP is fan total pressure that you can calculate from this equation. Efficiency of the fan we know or it is supplied by the manufacturer. So from that you can calculate the amount of work fan need to do or amount of power required from that. Now, various estimation of pressure losses and all these things we'll see in the next lecture. Our next lecture will be on the duct design especially. And in duct design, after studying the Bernoulli's equation, it is very important to estimate the pressure losses observed in the ducts, and accordingly we design the duct. Okay, so with this, I conclude today's session, and I hope all of you will join tomorrow for the next session for design on the design of the duct. Okay, thank you all.